10% in this quarter. Is it only to do with the slack season, slack season which impacted your revenues, or was there any other factor? And what's the outlook on your growth in FY16?
This quarter actually is most subdued growth quarter, particularly in terms of outbound, which really starts in the first quarter of this year. And our prediction for the next year going forward is quite robust, because our biggest segment today in terms of earnings is our education division. This is primarily based in Europe and Australia. And we have got some very good news that the estimated growth of primary school kids is 12% up in the UK, which means that, we can look forward to some double-digit growth in this education travel sector, which for us is our strongest single product. As far as India goes, again, we are incredibly bullish, because WTTC has come out with a very good prediction for Indian travel growth. They're saying that by 2025, we will actually see a doubling of the total revenues earned out of tourism in India. So I think that given these two trends, the relaxation of visa rules into India, we should see a fairly robust year in for this coming financial year.
Okay, so double-digit growth is what you're expecting in your education business, and India looks bullish as well. What will all this do to the margins? Your margins are still not yet at the double-digit mark. I think for this quarter, the adjusted margins are at 9.5%. For FY16, what could the margin and the trajectory look like?
The margin, if you look at our sort of EBITDA margins for the last 3 years, they've been incredibly robust and very, very steady. In fact, they've been at 40% plus margin for the last 3 years, and we don't see us changing that margin base, because it's a very steady income growth. And it's, this quarter, as we said, is an anomaly, because it's the slack season for our education. Our education centers actually shut down over the winter period. So you do see that a slight decline in that area, but if you see the whole year, our margins are very, relatively very steady on the EBITDA level.
Okay. So let's do previous contraction. You indicated that you are guiding for a 15% to 20% EBITDA growth for the consolidated entity at FY16, and a free cash flow guidance of 400 to 500 crore. Would there be any change to this guidance on margins as well as cash flow?
No, we came out with that guidance and we will stand by that guidance. So I think what is significant for this year is that if you see our last year, our balance sheet last year, our gross debt was almost 5,590 crores, and we've managed to reduce that gross debt by 1,800 crores. So it's a significant reduction in our debt. So we feel that the whole company outlook has completely transformed after this balance sheet item, and we believe that it should affect our future very, very significantly going forward.
Okay. In fact, coming to that, there has been a substantial reduction this quarter. So where does your debt stand at currently, and how much can you reduce it further by the end of FY16?
See, currently our net debt stands at 2,300 crores, and we anticipate that this quarter, if you see our last quarter, we did around 57 crores of interest was paid out, as opposed to 84, 85 crores in the previous quarters. So if you look at that, there's a saving of maybe 20 crores quarter on quarter. So this impact on us, just in terms of interest reduction, should be close to 100 crores a year, which should go straight to our bottom line. And in terms of free cash, as we gave the guidance, we'll stand by it, which means that we should see our debt coming down in the range of between 250 to 300 crores comfortably year on year.
Okay. The company has a massive chest and growing manager. In fact, you said that you would like to add, I think, 12,000 beds over there in the next 3 years. Any change to that assessment? How much of those total number of beds would be added in FY16?
Okay, what we did was, because this is a CapEx model, we tied up with the largest European hotel real estate REIT, which is called Transpenio. And what they have done is they've dedicated 400 million euros to assist in the buying out of the properties, which we then lease from them. And this is why we are so confident of delivering a total of 12,000 beds in a period of 4 years. Obviously, we expect that these beds will come through from year 17, 18, and 19 rather than 15, because a lot of these are new builds, and it takes us between 18 and 24 months to actually deliver on these properties. So you will see the real uplift in terms of beds only after 17. So 16 is a major year. We've just done the we've just done the agreement with them, and we're looking at the properties to invest as we speak.